In this tutorial, I'll show you how to replace screens with videos in After Effects. Let's get to it. Here we are in After Effects. I've got two different examples for this tutorial. In the first one, we're going to replace a laptop screen. In the second, we're going to replace an iPhone screen. Let's begin with the laptop. Here I have all the videos inside of the project window. I'm going to drag the laptop video onto the new composition icon, let go. That will create the composition that has the exact same size and frame rate as the video that we have, and that is exactly what we want. After creating the composition, I'm also going to add the video that we will be replacing this screen with. Since the laptop has a horizontal aspect ratio screen, I'm going to add a horizontal video below this one. After that, I'm going to double click on the laptop video layer. It will open in a separate window, and then we need the tracker panel. If you don't see it, go ahead to window and make sure tracker is checked, then come back to the tracker panel, click track motion button, and then set track type to be perspective corner pin. Then you should see the four points appear, which we need to place into the corners of the screen. Just drag them and place them in the corners. And after you've placed all four of the points, you can click Analyze Forward and let After Effects analyze the video. Just wait until this is done. And after the process is finished, we click on Edit Target. And if you've added the video beforehand, it should be over here. Select it, then click OK. And then click Apply button. And you're not going to see anything just yet because the video should be above the one with the laptop. So I'm going to bring it up. And here it is, replacing the laptop screen. So if you play this back, it will be attached to it nicely. And if you zoom in closely, you can see a tiny gap. And to hide that, you can simply select the video that we are replacing the screen with. Press S on a keyboard and increase the scale by 1% to hide that gap. So here we've replaced the screen on the laptop. Now let's move on to a next example where we're replacing the iPhone screen. So let's go back to the project panel, and I'm going to drag the iPhone video onto the new composition icon. And in case of using a phone that has a cutout, you should have a green screen of some kind that we can key out later in order to keep all of the details of the phone when replacing the screen. So the beginning steps are pretty much the same. Double click on the video, then inside of the tracker panel, click track motion, set track type to perspective corner pin, and position the four points accordingly. Then click Analyze Forward and wait for the process to finish. And after the tracking is done, I've actually stopped mine at about 6 seconds. We need to edit the target, but I haven't added the video just yet, so we can do that at this point. Since the phone has a vertical aspect ratio, I'm going to add a vertical video below this one. And then make sure you come back to the window where the iPhone video is open. Select the iPhone video on the timeline to go back to the tracker panel settings. Click Edit Target. And here, select the video that you want to apply, click OK, then click Apply. And we're not going to see anything just yet because the video needs to be at the top. So if we play this on top, you can see that the results are not acceptable. So let's bring this back down. And now we're going to open Effects and Presets, search for Keylight 1.2, add it to the video that has the iPhone. Then inside of the Effect Controls panel, we're going to select Screen Color, select the color picker, and select the color we want to key out. In this example, it would be green. And as we do that, we key out the green and we can see the video below. We still have some gaps that we can hide by selecting the video that we are replacing the screen with. Press S on the keyboard. And in case if the video looks a bit stretched, we can unlink the unit from scaling, decrease the Y scale slightly, then link it back and increase the overall scale until we cover all of the gaps. And here, if we give this a preview, we have perfectly replaced the iPhone screen without removing any of the details, such as the cutout and stuff like that. So that's how you replace screen on the iPhone, or any phone actually, and then the laptop, TV, or whatever it is. Thank you guys for watching.